At time like this, most of us want to do something to achieve world peace, but we don't know how to do it. Leaders don't seem willing to listen to their people's claims, and that gives us all a lot of frustration and anger. First of all, we have to remember that peace is much more than the absence of war or violent events. Peace is the absence of the possibility of war. It is a universal feeling, energy, that begins in us. Peace begins with us, and that eventually manifests itself in external events. This means that we cannot contribute to world peace without first having found our inner peace. If we want to achieve peace, the most powerful tool we have is our intention. Our intention works miracles, literally. If each of us succeeds in focusing our intention on achieving world peace, it's going to be easy to solve. But why haven't we? Constantly watching the coverage presented by the press, which is really propaganda, especially designed to weaken us. Don't tell me that this wasn't written yesterday. This is fear, courage, and frustration. Although, I would say anger, not courage. Although superficially we desire peace, many times we do not have it. Why don't we act as we should? Our intention for peace is not genuine. I hope I'm pronouncing that one right. It is very normal to be afraid of this type of situation, but we have to recognize it, accept it, and prevent it from controlling us. When we are feeling afraid, we have to remember that war is a temporary event and that after this, peace will come. We must visualize the ideal scenario of peace, oponopono. How would a completely peaceful world be like? Let's internalize you in that peace. How does that peace feel? What does it taste like? What does it look like? And actually, this, reminded me. Remember when Greg Braden says that he went with the Indians to do the ceremony to get rain because they didn't have rain? And remember what he says? But actually, I read it not long ago, from somebody else, yes? That this person says, okay, I would like to come with you. And the Indian says, okay, you can come. So they get to the top of this mountain. And the guy says, okay, what do I do? And the Indian says, you stay here. So the Indian goes and sits and do whatever ceremony, whatever. I mean, actually, I think in this case, he was totally in silence. And then he gets up, he comes to him and he said, let's go. And the guy says, that's it? That's all you're going to do? And says, yeah. So what did you do? I said, well, I imagine that it was raining. I could smell, the rain. I could smell the earth, wet. I could smell, the plants and everything, that smell of the rain brings, to nature. And that's it. And they said 3 days later, it was raining. So realize that we need to wake up to this. We are still very asleep of who we are and the power that we have. And because things are changing, we are going to be able to experience more and more this, of how we are the ones creating and we are the ones attracting. So we have to be more careful too of what we attract, what we think, et cetera, et cetera. Okay? To achieve inner peace, it is very important to disconnect from the sources of fear, television, press, etc. I'm telling you, this was written yesterday. And try to connect who we really are, beings created by love. It is also important that we dedicate time to activities which connect us with our inner peace, like Ho'oponopono. Relaxation is very important, even in the most difficult times, no matter what happens around us. If we think we don't have time to relax, then we really need it. Each of us must do our part. Believe me, once each of us achieves our inner peace, we will achieve world peace. Once we align our genuine intention in peace, we will make a significant difference. This way of achieving things is true with whatever goal we set out. Once we learn to put our genuine, intention, we will see how we will achieve everything automatically, effortlessly. I invite everyone to learn the philosophy of Ho'oponopono. I'm sure you will immediately see positive results. As always, no expectations. Okay, so I watched a 2-hour video yesterday of this guy that is a contactee. And the guy cries at one point. He says, we have to do it. We have to unite. This is the only race in all the galaxies that fight with each other, that they don't take care of each other. He says that this is the only place where people live on the streets and don't have something to eat. It's the only galaxy that this happens. And that makes you think, what kind of people are we? And we take it as normal. And I know we all have a big heart and we all want to care and everything, but think about it. Think about it. So if we are not gonna unite, if we are not gonna take care of each other, if we are not gonna come as a one human race, we don't have a chance. Really, because that's what this is all about. This is about really getting results, because I mean the demonstration don't get results actually. And actually will create a lot of chaos. That's what our enemy really wants. They want us on the streets. They want us with fear. They want us, you know, confused. That's their fuel. So think twice what you are choosing right now, what you are doing. This is time to go inside. This is time to be with ourselves. This is time to grow, to wake up, to do whatever, you know, work you can do to connect with how powerful you are. So it's very, very important. And as I always tell you, I mean, it is about declaring your freedom, choosing to be free. Because this is what we are actually, what is at stake right now. Okay? And we have to take it seriously. This is serious stuff. Very serious. Okay. So it is about love, it's not about fear, and it is taking responsibility. Believe me, if you are doing Ho'oponopono, don't worry about anything, okay? And on a different note, so we shake it out, we shake it off. Thank you for voting for my hairdo, but I'm going with my curls. I don't even recognize myself with that. I let the hairdresser to play with it, but I don't even recognize myself when I see that. But thank you. Thank you for voting. Thank you for commenting. Thank you for taking the time. Thank you for the nice things that you tell me. Okay. I'm still working with my new hairdo anyway, fighting with it. But I'm not gonna go straight. I mean, I don't feel myself there. I feel it's not me. And I have a story to tell you. So When I was little, I had curly hair, and sure, I hated it. So you wouldn't believe how much money my father paid for me when I was an adolescent to go to straighten it. Because right now I know there are other techniques and things like that. But at that time, you know, I had to go to the hairdresser for hours, and they would put all these products and things like that to make, you know, the hair, and it was expensive. But, you know, I wanted my hair straight, you know, and I had it long and straight. And then, you know, as I grew older, you know, I started, you know, wearing or my curly hair. And I always thought of my father. I said, poor my father, if he would see me now. Well, I'm sure he does, but I mean, he would be here. He would be complaining. He said, oh, now you wear it curly, huh? Okay, so to finish, I want to share something that I think is very important. We did something about cutting, you know, with the contracts and things, you know, previous contracts, things that we don't remember, yeah? And we did it when we didn't know better, okay? So I'm going to read something to you. I'm going to invite you to close your eyes. Just repeat mentally whatever feels comfortable with you that I'm reading. Whatever doesn't, you don't, okay? I'm going to drink some water first. Before I do this, I also want to remind you. What do I want to remind you? I'm trying to remind you something. Oh, that the lives now are saved in Instagram TV, IGTV. Okay? So if you want to watch this because you came late or whatever, or you didn't see it at all and now you found it, you're looking for it, I'm here in the IGTV, okay? Just in case, they are recorded. Anyway, they are in Facebook too, and then we are gonna put them in YouTube, okay? So the mini workshop of Zero Frequency was really, really good, really. I mean, humbly, okay? But I think it was very inspiring. And we did a lot of work about finding our passion and everything. And as you know, now it's been recorded. So you can still, if you didn't participate, you still can participate. But I just wanted to say that. Okay, I'm going to read, relax. Let's take a deep breath. Thanks to the change of cycle and making use of our free will, we declare ourselves as multidimensional, free, and sovereign human beings, being representatives of ourselves in this lifetime, the previous ones, and the upcoming one. Any contract, covenant, treaty, agreement, stipulation, or law that has been or will be signed without our consent is instantly revoked, as well as immediate invalidity of its terms and conditions due to the conscious beings that we are. We do not delegate our power. Our free will is sacred right, and is a sacred right and sealed by the law of manifested universe, and we strongly and firmly oppose any act that affects, infringes, violates, abducts, or retains this sacred right. We, as son of light, of water, rocks of heaven and earth, as well as the light and primordial darkness, we claim and proclaim to live in peace and harmony in this sacred world, which is our beloved Mother Earth, for being sons and true guardians. We claim to live in harmony with all living beings of the earth and its heavens, seas, lands and intralands. We claim to live in peace with everything that exists. We claim and proclaim before the spirit of the present and latent creation of our free will and radiate it to all conscious beings, true, free, and righteous with themselves and with their equal brothers in heart and essence. We claim and proclaim that our time has come to absolutely access all information classified as cosmic high secret, substantial foreign exchange, goods, gold, silver, and titles. We claim and proclaim to have in our hands the handling of legitimate food and education information, our full access to the true manuscripts left by our fathers, ending with the farce and manipulation of all the religions that exist, which were always unique, false knowledge and feeling. We claim and proclaim to connect with our older brothers, where each village will have their new representatives born and raised by their fathers from love, so that they may form new beings who will never seek war, but the brotherhood of their village. We claim and proclaim as free beings the absolute dissemination and our access to all the hidden technology that is far ahead of everything that is seen and known to this day. We claim and proclaim the total and absolute liberation of medical technology that will transform us into beings free of all disease, living for centuries in a state of excellence, because in our Mother Earth there is room for all her interstar sons. While existing very delicate and evolved form of self-controlling the population of the star nation of which we are part of. We claim and proclaim the uprising of the forgotten veil to exercise our right and remember our freedom through the infinity of interwinds connected, generated from the individuality and singularity which all of us are in initial intent and shared purpose. We claim and proclaim our liberation of bonds and energy, chains of ignorance, pain, and fear that hold us to this day, in a reality already learned, encompassed, and widely overcome to consider and manifest in us. As living beings of humanity from the surface of Mother Earth, the fifth dimension and density of freedom and beyond. We claim and proclaim contact with countless star civilizations who inhabit the worlds and dwellings that the Creator Source has placed in this universe. This declaration must be considered and accepted before any terrestrial, extraterrestrial, or interdimensional instance, at any time, in any situation, time and space. We make clear and firmly expose this declaration that no so-called Mother Earth ruler, it is so-called dominators or self-proclaimed interlocutors do not represent us under any circumstances, neither now nor ever. We impose our right to our free will as an indelible, unique and sovereign signature in this declaration. Okay? Everything that says here is like that. Okay? And it's time for us to choose this, because this could be all available to us. It was hidden to us. Okay? So it is our right, and we can claim it now. It's our turn. But for that, it's, like I said, it's not over yet. We still have, and we will have to be very much in our center. We will have to be let go and trust. I let go and trust. I let go and trust. I'm not going to worry. Okay. We are going to use the gold ring to protect ourselves. We are going to seal ourselves, you know, vacuum seal ourselves like the food. Yes. We can put the floor, the lease on the situation. We are going to trust, trust, trust. There is no room to doubt now. And definitely please do not watch the news, or at least if you watch it, do not believe it. Believe them, nothing. And please, 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 okay? It's time to unite. It's time to realize we are really a family. It's time to show the universe that we can do it. Because we can, if we unite, if we become one big family, if we take care of each other. But again, it starts with us. Peace begins with me, begins with you. And that's the only way to spread peace. That's the only way to spread happiness, becoming happy, letting go of the past, forgiving. Believe me. Nothing compares when the truth will come out, that I don't know by now when, but when the truth will come out, you will see that whatever was done to you was nothing compared to what you didn't do, know that it was done to you and to all of us. Okay? Please, please wake up. It's time to wake up. It's time to wake up. We need to save the earth. We need to save ourselves. And then we are going to be able to save the earth. We still need more people awakened. Okay? So we do our part. We do our part. Okay? No sacrifices. This is not the year of sacrifice. And maybe you will have to let go of things that you are attached to, people that you are attached to. But we can do it. Let's do it, guys. Let's wake up. Let's work on ourselves. We'll be so proud of ourselves when all this is over. Wow. We will really have a lot of excuses to celebrate. We can do it. Come on. Okay. Do not go out to demonstrate. Do not feed the chaos. Do not feed the doubts. Do not feel the fear. We cannot keep being fueled for those that want to harm us, okay? That's what they feel they feed from. So we have to stay at peace, okay? You can count on me, I think. I hope I can count on you. We are all on this together. I love you. Take good care of yourself. I love you, really, really. And I'm grateful. I'm grateful you're here. Thank you. Thank you for showing up in my life. Oh, guys. Bye.